Equipping them certainly thank God that our purpose and our mission is to promote the gospel of Jesus Christ through effective, responsible ministry and intentional, dynamic, creative fellowship. And we certainly thank God for our core values, our values that we have received to help us to establish ourselves as the people of the kingdom of God. We value love, we value patience, we value persistence, we value commitment, sacrifice, and service. Come on and give God a praise. And in our prayers that we pray one for another, we also want to pray for our church that we fulfill and complete the mission that God has given unto us. It's not good enough if you started. It's good enough you've got to continue to the end. Amen? The Bible says, they that continue to the end, the same shall be saved. So we want to be about our Father's business. And the first order of business in this service is that we want to invoke the presence of God here in this place. And by doing that, we want to pray. How many of you know the Bible declares that we ought to always pray and not to faint? We need prayer. Thank you, Jesus. We need prayer in our lives. Don't we need prayer in our lives? We need prayer in our communities. We need prayer especially in our sanctuaries where we worship God. And your home can be a type of sanctuary, a closed place, a place where you can meet up with the Lord and commune and fellowship with Him. God wants to fellowship with us. God wants to love upon us. But we have to draw nigh to Him. If we draw nigh to Him, He'll draw nigh to us. God is faithful. The Bible says it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because His compassions, they fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is the faithfulness of God. And your compassions, the compassion that God has for you, will never fail. It will never run out. It will never run dry. And if you look up that word compassion, it means to aid you in your time of trouble. God wants to aid you in your time of trouble. Not only does He want to just help you, but He wants to aid you. He wants to pick you up. He wants to turn you around. He wants to deliver you. He wants to set your feet on that solid ground. Hallelujah. God is like this. Can I tell you how God is? Everywhere you go, God wants to go. Amen. Everywhere God goes, He wants you to go with Him. Amen. In other words, God never wants to be without you, and you should never want to be without your God. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on and give Him one more praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And if we do it right, we'll never take God into places He don't want to go. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So we certainly want to go before the Lord in prayer. And it's an hour of consecration in prayer. And if you ever thought about it, I don't know if you ever thought about it or not, that 11 o'clock generally services get started around the world. And it's time to pray. Amen. It's a consecrated hour to pray. It's a consecrated time to seek your God. So if you make your request known before the Lord, I'm sure that God will hear your request. And whether or not He answers it, let it be according to His will. Amen. That's how much we trust Him. We trust that He'll do the right thing. Am I right? Hallelujah. So that way, when you do it that way, you don't have to worry. You don't have to fret. Hallelujah. Because you know God is going to do what's right. So if you have a prayer request, you can stand now and let it be done. Amen. All right, pray for the success of the service on today. Pray that the Lord will have His way. Deacon Fields?
Yeah, my prayer request is for the elderly.
Pray for the elderly.
With the COVID, the people who have to visit this house.
Yes.
They have been back to visit
them. Uh-huh.
And pray that the Lord will test their heart and start visiting
them again. Yes. Amen. Turn things around. And that's true. We're coming out of this pandemic, and so we need to turn the ship around. Sister Hall, praise the Lord. Yes.
About the city, all over the world. Let's continue to pray much for the body of Christ. Pray much for my son. Pray much for me and Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Certainly do want to pray for the bereaved families. I had the honor of doing something I never did before on yesterday. Helped to officiate a Sudanese service, and people from Sudan, and one of their loved ones perished, and you know, their service is a little different from our service, but you know, nevertheless, let us pray for all bereaving families as God would have his way, amen, and comfort the hearts of the people. One thing that I didn't get out of the service is that all people grieve the same. Amen. You may not go through the functionality of the service the same. The order of the service may be different. But the pain is the same. The grief is the same. So the love of God must be the same. The worship that they had was the same. Amen. We got to trust God. How many of you know you got to trust God? Lord, I trust you. Thank you, Lord. I trust you. Let the church stand. Saints, don't stop praying, for the Lord is nigh. Saints, don't stop praying, hear the little cry. For the Lord has promised, and his word is true. Just keep on praying, he'll answer you. Saints, don't stop praying, for the Lord is nigh. Saints, don't stop praying, he'll hear your cry. For the Lord has promised, and his word is true. Just keep on praying, he'll answer you. Saints, don't stop praying. Yes, Lord. The Lord is mighty, even in that hour. Never stop. He'll hear your cry. The Lord has promised. All of God's word is true. Jesus. Lord, as we link our hearts and minds together on this day, as we come together unified, seeking your face and to calling upon your name. Lord, you said in your word, if by people that will call by their name and your name but humble themselves and pray. Lord, we're humbling ourselves before you and we're praying. And Lord, we're seeking your face and we're turning from every wicked way. Lord, you promised that you would hear from heaven, that you would forgive our sins, and that you would heal our land. You promised, Lord, that you would humble us and keep us in the center of your will if we call upon your holy and precious name. Now, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, as we come boldly to the throne of grace, Lord, we pray, Lord, that you have mercy on each and every one of us that are here under the sound of my voice, that you have mercy upon us, O God, that you blood wash us and cleanse us, and that you purge us from all unrighteousness, from every word, thought, deed, and every secret thought. Lord, we confess our faults. We confess our faults. We confess our faults. We confess our faults before you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord, we pray that you cleanse us. Let the blood of Jesus, let the blood of Jesus cover us. Let the blood of Jesus wash us. Let the blood of Jesus purge us. Cleanse us from all our iniquities. Cleanse us from all of our sins. Lord, make our motive right. Make our heart right in the name of Jesus. So that we may serve you, Lord. So that we may worship you, Lord. So that we may give you thanks in the sanctuary. So that we may praise your holy name in the sanctuary. In the sanctuary. In the sanctuary, Lord. We want to hear from you. In the sanctuary, Lord. We want to call upon you, Lord, and see your miracles, your signs, and your wonders.
You are not alone. You are not alone in your mess. You are not alone. wall. Because we were ready to do this. My son got some more work to do in the kingdom. And you ain't giving up like that.
That's right.
Giving up just easy.
Yeah.
You got work to do.
Yeah.
But I want y'all to remember this week that he shall fight. But he shall not. Prevail. Why? Because no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. And every lying tongue.
morning will start me on my way. My hallelujah belongs to you. Come on, say, my hallelujah belongs to you. For keeping me through the pandemic, Father, my hallelujah belongs.
Hallelujah. My hallelujah. He deserves it. Beauty. Come on, church. Yes, Lord.
Thank you.
is great. I said, God is great. I said, God is great. And he's greatly to be praised. I said, how many of you know God is greatly to be praised? Has God been great in your life? Has he done some great things for you? Can you ascribe greatness to your God? Hallelujah. How great is his name? He's the only one forever the same. He's the one that held back the waters of the mighty Red Sea. He said, I'll be with you. Just put your trust in me. How many are trusting in the Lord on today? How many of you just come too far by faith to give up now? How many of you just leaning on the Lord? How many of you just leaning on the Lord? How many of you just leaning on Jesus? How many of you just leaning on Jesus? I'm leaning on Jesus. How many of you just leaning on Jesus? Lord, I'm leaning. I'm leaning on you, Jesus. I'm leaning on you, Jesus. Can you say you're leaning on him? Can you say you're trusting in him? Can you say you're waiting on him? Hallelujah. How many of you can say, I don't mind waiting? I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting on you, Lord. I don't mind waiting on you, Lord. Father, while I'm waiting, I'm going to praise you. While I'm waiting, I'm going to thank you. While I'm waiting, I'm going to worship you. While I'm waiting, I'm going to give you glory. I'm going to give you honor. And I'm going to give you peace. While I'm waiting, I'm going to be obedient to your name. Yeah, I'm going to give you an echo shot. Hallelujah. While you're waiting, you're going to praise him. While you're waiting, you're going to worship him. While you're waiting, you're going to trust him. Trust you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You know, as the praise and worship going on, my mind went back to the convention that we had. I don't know what city it was in, but it was an older guy. He was there. And when the praise and worship was going on, he would wind up. Just take a leap. You can wind up and take a leap. You can get across to the altar. And the Lord said, we got to leap before the Lord. Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And he did not leap before the Lord. And you know, the thought is, that's what the Lord gave him to maintain the victory. Yeah. Now, it may look foolish to stop, but if God has given it to you, if God is laying it upon your heart, you ought to praise him. You ought to give thanks unto the Lord. You ought to magnify the name of the Lord because he's worthy to be praised. How many know the Lord is worthy? How many know that the Lord is worthy? How many know that you know that the Lord is worthy? That your soul shall take a boast in the Lord. And now humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Hallelujah. We praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We praise God for you today. Thank you. Hallelujah. Victory belongs to Jesus. I said, victory belongs to Jesus. I said, victory belongs to Jesus. And because it belongs to Jesus, it belongs to us as well. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. That's why we can say, thanks be to God that giveth us the victory through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. As we have already set the protocol and have already magnified the name of the Lord, hallelujah, and have already given honor to whom honor is due, we certainly do want to once again honor each and every one of you. Also, too, when praise and worship was going on in my mind, I said it's in my mind, but it was also in the sanctuary. But you got to have praise and worship in your mind, too. Amen. Not just on the outside, it's got to be on the inside. Amen. How many of you know that? Thank you, Lord. It's got to be, hallelujah, it's got to be going on the inside to be effective. Amen. So as I was praising and worshiping our God, I was thanking God for all of you, Christian Ministries. Come on, give God a praise. Father, I thank God for you. I thank God that you have pressed your way and made an intentional desire, amen, to come and be with us. And we thank God for that. Come on, give God a praise. And we certainly praise God, amen, for those that are tuning in with us virtually. And I thank God also, too, for the sacrifice of Brother Ed Duro and Sister Clarissa Hicks. Amen. Come on, give God a praise for our media team. Amen. The sacrifice that they make. And we pray and trust that God is continually blessing you as you bless us and work for the kingdom. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. My God. My God. Thank you, Jesus. And we praise God for that. And we certainly thank God for Minister Quinn, who's has officially relocated here in Erie. Amen. We want to give God a praise. Amen. He'll be working there at the VA hospital. Come on, give God a praise. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You know, I pray that the Lord will bless him with everything that he needs. Amen. Hallelujah. And we certainly praise God for that. We thank God for the report of Sister Stephanie's son. Amen. Coming out of the hospital, being healed to live. Amen. We praise God for that. And we certainly praise God for each and every soul, once again, that is here with us on today. And by way of announcements, God is blessing us. He's blessing us and he's moving in different ways. And this week, I want you to pray in a critical way for Christian Ministries in this week, because we have two things that are critical that we've been waiting for that are on the plate. On Thursday, May 20th, Thursday, May 20th, this Thursday, if the Lord say the same, we'll be moving toward closing on the building of 31st Street. There's been a lot of struggle with that. There's been the enemy has shown his hand, and we keep casting him down, and you know, he come up with different other ways. So continue to pray. Amen. Pray for that. And also, too, another key component of the vision that God has for Christian Ministries will be having our final daycare inspection on Friday, the 21st, at 10 o'clock. Come on, give God a praise. So this week we'll be setting up the daycare area. The Deacon Davis, Grady Davis Chapel, is right now being transformed into a daycare center, where we'll have our daycare center. And then with the hopes of eventually, because we got to do some renovations upstairs, and hopefully we'll be moving it upstairs in a certain amount of time. Man, we'll put no time limit on God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. But that's the goal, to move it upstairs and to return the chapel to the chapel. Amen. And our daycare will be open, the grand opening, moving forward, will be July 5th. Will be July 5th. Come on, that's right. Come on, God. Thank you, Jesus. And we'll be serving ages from 2.5 to 12 years old. And the daycare will be open from 6 to 6. And we have a total of 32 slots. Currently, right now, we have 9 kind of part-time teachers that are teaching. We need a total roster of 14. So if you know anybody that wants to be a daycare teacher, a daycare aide, see me and we'll work through the process. I didn't know that they provide. I know people were telling me, you know, I don't want to jump into it and receive it. All they give a lot of education, they give a lot of information, they give a lot of aid, and they give a lot of funds for daycares. Amen. And the educational part is not that expensive, you know, and they do assist. So the reason why I say that, I'm a proponent of education, a proponent of learning, and it's good to learn. It's good to keep your, that's what keeps your mind fresh.
Amen.
Amen. You learn getting into it. So if you want to be involved, please let me know. So having said that then, all of our services, church and religious services then, will be held in this facility, in our sanctuary, and then moving forward. That door there will be unlocked for Bible study and things such as that. So this will be the place, amen, for our Bible study, for our prayer, and for our worship. Amen? Amen. So we thank God for that. We thank God for that. All right. I'm looking at my little notes. I'm trying to be proficient here. All right. So next on the agenda, Bolden at the Green Garden Lanes with Christian Ministries. And that's going to take place June 5th, 2021 from 1 to 3 for 2 hours of Bolden. So if you want to sign up for Bolden, please see Deacon Fields so we can make arrangements to get you there and to have a good time in the Lord. And this Bolden extravaganza is free of charge and is being paid for by the New York, Pennsylvania, New England States Council, where I'm the council chairman, amen, Sunday school department, where the council chairman of that department is Elder Gerald Baines. So we want to thank God for him. Deacon Fields, when this event occurs, if we can just send him a thank you card, that would be good. It's good to say thank you, didn't it? Amen. It's good to say thank you. And so we want to do that. Amen. And we certainly do thank God for our visitor here today, Carlos. Amen. Is it Trencher? Trench, Carlos. Carlos, you ain't no visitor no more, man. So you don't have to fill out this no more. We thank God for you. Amen. We certainly do thank God for each and every one of us. How many of you know it's blessing time? It's blessing time. It's blessing time in the sanctuary. The Bible says it's more blessed to give than to receive. And the Bible tells us that God loves a cheerful giver. He wants you to give your tithe and your offering to go to his house so that it would be meet in his house. Amen. Thank you, Lord. So we thank God for everyone here that participates. Amen. Thank you, Lord, in fellowship with Christian Ministries. And we trust that God has laid on your heart to give your tithes and your offerings to this particular ministry. And because when you do that, there's blessings that are connected with it. Amen. Thank you. Come on in, brother. He said, for sure. See, you don't make me act like that up in here. My wife looking at me. Thank you, Lord. Come on, somebody give God a praise. Hallelujah. God, Pastor Beckham used to say, God said, try me. Amen. See when I open up the windows of heaven and pour you out blessings that you won't have room enough to receive. You can't be God given. Amen. He'll turn around and give you 30, 60, and 100-fold. So we want to ask the church to stand. Just put your seed in your hand as a seed offering of faith. Thank you, Lord. And as we deliver the seed of faith and we plant it in good soil, Lord, we are expecting a harvest according to your will, according to your which is in glory. Gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask you, Lord, that you bless this offering and bless those that are giving and bless those that are receiving. Use it for your glory and the building of your kingdom. Father, we thank you and praise you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. All right. Just you can turn your over to the hands of our ushers. Yes, all the glory belongs to you. James chapter number 5, and just drop down with me to verse number 7. James chapter number 5 and verse number 7. James is the brother of Jesus. Amen. It says, be patient, therefore, brethren, unto the coming of the Lord. Behold, take notice, the husbandman waited for the precious fruit of the earth and had long patience for it until he received the early and the latter rain. Be ye also patient, establish your hearts, for the coming of the Lord draweth nigh. Grudge not one against another, brethren, lest ye be condemned. Behold, the judge standeth before the door. Take, my brethren, the prophets, who have spoken in the name of the Lord, for an example of suffering affliction and of patience. Behold, ye count them happy who which endure. You have heard of the patience of Job, and have seen the end of the Lord, that the Lord is very pitiful and of tender mercy. But above all things, my brethren, swear not neither by heaven, neither by earth, neither by any other oath, but let your yea be yea, and your nay, nay, lest ye fall into condemnation. Gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we certainly thank you for this word on today. We thank you, Lord, for the anointing that is in this place. We ask you, Lord, that you anoint your vessel one more time. Anoint these thy great people, that anoint their ears, the ear to the soul. And Lord, that we may obey your word and receive it with meekness to the saving of our soul. Father, we ask you to provide clarity of thought and speech. And we ask you these many blessings in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I just want to take a brief thought for today in your hearing. It's the job of the preacher. I've learned through many toils and preaching sessions, I said sessions, preaching times, that it's my beginning of preaching. First started out preaching, I used to try to preach the whole Bible in one session. Thank you, Lord. That ain't good. That ain't good because you don't leave the people with a thought. God wants you to be left with a thought in your mind. And I want to take a thought from that verse number 8, St. James chapter number 5, and verse number 8, it says, be ye also patient. As you can tell that through those verses that I read, Paul must have said, be patient, about 6 or 7 times. Yeah. Be ye also patient, establish your hearts, for the coming of the Lord draweth nigh. The coming of the Lord is close. And I want to take for a thought on this morning or afternoon, be patient unto the coming of the Lord. Be patient unto the coming of the Lord. And it goes without saying that we ourselves live in a society that is not patient, that does not know how to wait. And in Jesus' day, he made an analogy about being patient, and James used the same analogy about being patient as a farmer. A farmer has to be patient. A farmer has to have the ability to wait. Jesus said that My Father is the husbandman. I am the vine, and my Father is the husbandman, and ye are the branches. He said that every branch in me that beareth fruit, he purchased it. He purchased it so that it can bring forth more fruit. Every farmer wants to bear fruit. Every farmer wants to receive a crop. And every farmer has to be patient to wait on the crop to grow. They have to wait on things to happen. And some things that they're waiting on things to happen is out of their control. They gotta wait for the right time. They gotta wait for the right season. And as the scripture says here, they have to wait for the early and latter rain. And those rainy seasons, the one rain, the early rain, it breaks up the fallow ground. The latter rain, then, which that early rain is in October, when they start to plant. And that latter rain happens in April, May, wherein it rejuvenates and revives so that they can receive and harvest. Sometimes that rain may be delayed. Sometimes that rain won't happen. But they still have to be patient. They have to be patient. We ourselves can learn a lot from farmers by being patient. God tells us to wait on him. Farmers had to wait on the Lord because rain was out of their control. They weren't like Indians to do a rain dance and the rain come. Thank you, Lord. And they couldn't do tricks and things such as that and wait on the rain. The rain has to come from God. And oftentimes the Bible tells us that we have to wait on the Lord. And how do we wait on the Lord? We got to be of good courage. If you're being patient and discouragement comes, it can get you impatient. Now I didn't hear me. If you're being patient and waiting on God, and if you allow discouragement to happen, you're throwing the towel. You give up. You go from one idea to the next. You try to make it happen your way instead of allowing God to develop it his way. That's what happened to Sarah. Abraham, they wanted a son. God had given them the promise, but they became impatient while they waited for the promise. And then Sarah came up with an idea that her husband went along with. Y'all know the story. Went into Hagar, and sure enough, they had a son, but they didn't do it God's way. Didn't do it God's way. They were impatient. When you put yourself in a hurry and get discouraged, it weighs on your patience. So the Bible says, wait on the Lord and be of good courage. Let me hasten. The Bible tells us in this particular passage that it says, be therefore patient, brethren, unto the coming of the Lord. Then it says, the husbandman waited for the precious fruit of the earth. And this is an analogy unto God. God is patient. God is trying to get a number together, and he had long patience. Somebody say long patience. How many know that the long suffering or the long patience of God is salvation? God is not in a hurry. God is not in a hurry. And his job is to save. It's not the will of God that anyone should perish, but that all would be saved. So God is waiting. God is waiting with all long suffering for people to turn unto him. As the scripture said, that Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give thee rest. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for my yoke is easy and our burden is light. God is patient with us. God waits on us. And you know, that being patient, it really means he endures us. You know that before you even came to Christ, you were stiff-necked. You were rebellious. You did your own thing. But God was patient. You said some things that were out of the way, but God was patient. I'm so glad that God does not foreclose on us as we deserve. That God deals with us in mercy. That God deals with us in love. That God deals with us according to his kindness. I'm so glad that God is patient. And I'm so glad that he waits on us to get a mindset to turn unto him. He waits on us that we might repent and get a new heart and desire God. God help me in my uneasiness. Help me. Hallelujah. That I may come out of this situation. Lord, sometimes we say, God, when I get myself together, I'll get myself together and I'll come to you. But if you try to get yourself together, I'm sure you're still in that mess. You're still in that situation. Because you need God. It is God that gets us together. It is God that helps us. It is God that strengthens us. And as the Bible says, it is in him that we live. It's in him that we move. It's in him that we have our being. And as long as I'm saying that I don't get it together, Lord, and I'm coming to you, I'm going to straighten out myself, and I'm coming to you, you'll be stuck in your mess. You'll be stuck in your situation. Because God is the one that's got to help you. God is the one that's got to strengthen you. God is waiting for you to get a revelation to realize that I'm nothing without the Lord. That if I get the Lord's shot, if Jesus doesn't do it, it can't be done. If the Lord don't make me new, if the Lord don't change me over, if the Lord don't help me, then you gotta know where your help comes from. How many of you know where your help comes from? You gotta say, Lord, I'm looking to the hills, from whence cometh my help. Can I preach up in here just for a minute that God knows because he developed the thought or the theory of farming. He knows when you get some bad ground, you got to dig and you got to dug it. He knows you got to cultivate, my God, that ground, that plant a good seed. And he knows that you got to water that seed and take care of that seed. And he knows that you got to prune things that get in the way. And he knows that he got to put a hedge of protection about it because there's some evil viruses. There's some evil animals. There's some evil threats to the crop that wants to destroy it. And you know, that's how God looks at us. He looks at us in a certain way that realizes that we start out as fallow ground. That we start out that we need to be dug and we need to be digged. He knows that he's going to plant a seed in us, and that seed needs time to germinate. That seed needs time to take root. That seed needs time to grow and to bear forth fruit. So God knows that seed, and you need some protection in your life so that in the process of time that you'll be like that tree planted by the rivers of water, that you may bring forth fruit in your season. You see, God is looking for you to bring forth fruit. God is looking for you to bring forth in your season. You see, God himself, he put this treasure, the Bible says, in earthen vessels. God has put a treasure in you. God has put something in you. God has delivered you. He brought you out of darkness and into his marvelous light. God has set you in a place where you can hear his word so that you can develop faith, that you may hear the plan and the wisdom of God. God is saying, I wanted to go into your heart. I want every emotion. I want you to choose me. I want you to love on me. I want you to seek me while I'm naked, Father. I want you to call on me while I'm near. I want you to forsake evil and choose the good.
You have some wisdom, and you're
answer. I wait on you. You wait on me. Come on, give God a praise.
Hang on. come. Your peace will come. Your power will come. Your mighty shining armor. Everybody's shot. He'll crack the star. He'll take up our people. You gotta wait. Come on, you're waiting. Let me just say this. The purpose of enduring is so you can make the right choice. Huh? You gotta make the right choice. Am I right? God allows you to be in a situation until you make the right choice. Y'all don't hear me out here. He wants you to choose him. And sometimes, this is what God does. Sometimes, because he knows what's in our heart, right? He knows what's in our mind, right? And he wants us to make the right choice, am I right? So sometimes he'll take some stuff away from you. He may take your house away. He may take your car away. Amen. Because sometimes we trust in those uncertain riches. Amen. Sometimes we think of God as a sugar daddy. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And God don't want that. I know that's bad English. God does not want that. So and what he does, he don't tempt you with evil, but God will put you in a test. So that if that's gone, what will you do? If that's missing, what will you do? Will you choose God that's able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you're able to ask for it? Or will you walk away? Can't walk away from God. Where shall I go? When those disciples were preaching, 70 of them, and Jesus told them, you got to eat of my flesh. You got to drink of my blood. And the majority walked away. Why? Because they got affected. Blessed is he that is not affected in me. They walked away. Jesus didn't trip. He looked at his 12 disciples. He said, we can also go. And notice Peter said, Lord, whither shall we go? You alone have the words of life. If you get stripped down to nothing, stick with your God. If everything with money walking out on you, stick with your God. If no money in your pocket, stick with your God. Hungry as a dog, stick with your God. Choose him. Choose him. And while you're making a choice, be patient. Be patient. Be patient. Even some worldly people got that kind of understanding. These rich people that's looking for a husband or a wife, they'll dress down, drive a hoopty, you know, and sit there and make conversation. And if the person doesn't love them for who they are, they know. Amen. And they move on, trying to find somebody that's going to love them for them. God just don't want you to love him for the fishes and the loaves. God wants you to love him for him. You ought to have a message change. Father, God wants you to love him for who he is. Not for what he can do for you, but for who he is. Let the church stand. I got to kick y'all over. And I'll forgive the old pastor. Hallelujah. I got another preach in me. Y'all give me about another hour. Hey! Hallelujah! This thing is real! Wait on the Lord! Tell you about the wait on the Lord! Hallelujah! Evangelist Aaron, to wait on the Lord!
Thank you for calling. Present you for us.
presence with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, to him be glory and honor and forever. In Jesus' name, the Lord says, shut your mouth. Amen. 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 Come on, give God praise.